Sure. I don't think anybody's that fast. But this year, it's interesting because they've made some changes, and they're actually excluding half of the competitors from last year.
Yeah, it seems like a drastic move. They're barring men from competing in this year's race, but there's a very specific reason for doing so. Fox 31's Emily Allen joining us live to explain. Em?
This is a big step that they're taking, but the whole reason behind this is that they are trying to fight for equality for women in sports. And so they said this year they want this to just be about women and really take a stand in the fight for equality. If you're headed down here, you're going to see plenty of signs of that race already. Even though it's not coming here until Sunday, you can see that they have some roadblocks already set up, just kind of getting them staged to put into position. And then you'll also see, too, signs alerting people that they won't be able to park on certain streets on Sunday when this race comes here. This is a big race. There are 100 women, the top 100 women riders in the world that are competing in this race. And it's the third year now in a row that this is happening. With all of this in mind, you think of a female-only race, all of these women that are in this. Organizers say it's the only one of its kind in the Western Hemisphere. And again, they are fighting for equal pay and equity for women in sports. And we asked the spokesperson why they felt like it was important to take this stand this year. And he said, there's been so much conversation about this on the world stage. You have women's soccer, women's hockey that are all fighting for equity, and so they really wanted to get involved in this, take a stand, and so that's why they decided to do this. Women will be competing in Avon today in the second leg of the race, kicked off yesterday in Steamboat, and then it's going to happen in Golden tomorrow and then in Denver on Sunday. And you guys were talking about that map. We'll pull it up for you one more time. That race starts at Coors Field. Athletes will race to City Park. They'll do several laps around a course that set up there before heading back downtown, and there will be lots of places if you're interested in watching or coming out with your family, plenty of places where you can come and watch this race go by. Some of those closures are starting as early as 5 a.m. here downtown. The next big round happens at 10 a.m. and then 1 p.m. right before the start of the race. And then from what I'm seeing, it looks like all of those roads open back up at about 4:45 p.m. Emily Allen, Fox 31.
Well, Emily, what do the winners get?
So there's cash prizes for the winners, and that's another thing that they're doing too that's different this year. They are making sure that they are paying the women more for their winnings this year than they paid any of the men in the last 2 years. Again, to go on that theme of trying to work for equity and for women in sports.
All right, and it sounds like Sunday's going to be one of the busier days, especially for folks who are downtown. How many of these bicyclists will we see down there?
You know, it's getting narrower and narrower as the days go on. So you started with 100 yesterday in Steamboat, but they have to make a certain time for each of these legs of the race. And so by the time they get here on Sunday, it's going to be a really small pool of the top athletes.
All right. Emily Allen live for us in downtown Denver. Thanks, Emily. Governor Pol is talking about the changes this year to the Colorado Classic, saying he supports the bold move in becoming a women's only race. Also saying, quote, it's a perfect match as the Colorado Classic reflects what our state is known for, innovation and inclusion, while showcasing Colorado's diverse outdoor health and wellness lifestyle. An update.